Hey, I'm treasure hunting today. I found a treasure down here yesterday. I talked myself into coming back and getting it. I'll show you guys what I'm getting and how cheap I got it for. Yeah, stay tuned. I found some other treasures too. I'll share them all with you in this episode. We'll be right back. Hello, welcome back to Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. I'm on the treasure hunting series, of course. I'm at one of my favorite places to go to. It's the Goodwill. You can find all kinds of treasures in here. I was down in here yesterday just looking for a couple of items. Again, still finding those pieces to my china set. It's called the Royal Rose China Ensemble. My little brother gave me a set of china for Christmas when I was 21 years old, and it wasn't until a couple years ago I was able to get them out of the boxes and put them into this china hutch that I purchased for my blushing bride that matches our beautiful dining room set. Anyway, we're getting it together, found out they have more pieces to this china set. I found a teapot, found a coffee pot, now I've been looking for cream and sugar, and found a gravy boat. Yeah, I got my cream and sugar containers and found a gravy boat, and now I'm looking for, I think the final piece is a butter dish. And then that's the final piece to this ensemble that completes my set. Yeah, I found them cheap. Now we're gonna go in here when they open. I'm a little bit early. I got about, 8 minutes to go before they do open the doors for me, but I'm coming in. I see the thing through the window. It's a piece I want. We're gonna go in and get it right away before somebody else snags it. That's why I brought my pickup with me. Yeah, yeah. We'll be right back. This is it. This is what I'm after. This thing right here. It's a hall coat rack, hat rack, beveled mirror. And look at the price. Plus I get my veteran's discount. It's mine now. Yes. And it does have shelves, so I got a perfect use for that. Okay, let's get it home.
Maybe I didn't think it was.
Okay, I like this. Roadside Treasures. Check this out. A barbecuer. I found my last barbecuer on the roadside, but this one's in a lot better shape than mine. And look at this. Yep. We got it loaded. We're gonna get it home. I'm gonna clean it up, get some special cleaner for getting the grease out and polishing up that stainless steel. That's a nice unit. Free. Fits my budget. I'll put my old barbecuer up on the end of my driveway. Maybe somebody will want that, at least for scrap, if anything. Anyway, let's get the stuff home. Well, we made it back home. I found a spot for that roadside find. Every once in a while, I find these treasures on the roadside. It just so happened I picked up this barbecue. It's a beautiful barbecue. I've been wanting a one like this, so I went ahead and took my barbecuer up to the end of my driveway, and that sucker disappeared within about 10 minutes. Gone. Anyway, I went and polished this up with some simple green, some Windex, and some Brasso. Yes, the Brasso got the stainless steel cleaned up really good. It also got the rust stains off. And there was some stubborn grease spots on there that I couldn't get off. So here's a Homestead hack. I used boiling hot water. I just heated up a coffee mug of water in the microwave, dumped it on there, wiped it right off, because that heat just dissolves it. And so that's a hack for you guys for getting any adhesive or sticky or grainy stuff off really easy. Hot boiling water.
Cleaned up really nice. I put the propane bottle on there. I've got down stored down here in my cast iron skillet and cookware for cooking outdoors. I also have my tools I store down here. And then I got my pot holders, my towel and stuff ready for barbecuing. Turned it on just to check out the gauge to see if it does work, and it does work. It heats up. The side burner works. Everything works. I'm happy. Now we're ready for barbecuing. This thing cleaned up really nice. And now in the dining room, I mentioned that I had ordered some pieces for my china selection. It's the Royal Rosebud selection. I found them cheap on eBay. That's another resource to find cheap. And so I went ahead and ordered the creamer and the sugar, and I found a gravy boat with a tray under it. I purchased all three items, and they'll be coming and adding to my rosebud pattern china set. Now, the china was a gift to me when I was in my early 20s from my little brother for Christmas. Sat in boxes for about 40 some odd years until I was able to purchase this china hutch that I got actually off of Craigslist. The china hutch matches the dining room table that I also found on Craigslist. And then all these items I either got from Craigslist, an estate cleanup, or they were gifts. So we're keeping it cheap. Like the coffee maker, or the coffee pot and the teapot here matches my same pattern for the china. I got those out of the thrift shop. Did not know they existed, but I was pleasantly surprised. So my wife and I, we do have a champagne taste, but we're able to live on a beer budget. Now over here, we did find a spot for that antique hallway coat rack. I built an extra wide entryway. That's right, I built the entryway. And it was able to display my fine art that I've been collecting from the thrift shop. $20 down to $1.29. There's a couple of pieces here that I purchased for, $2.29, and they're valued at over $900 each. But anyway, I found the spot for this little piece, dusted it off. It came with a little glass shelf down in the curio part, and yes, it does have a light on there, so I was able to put a vase in there that I did buy at the thrift shop. And there's a couple of little things, the egg I found at the thrift shop, and this little penguin figurine my wife got as a gift from her sister. The pitcher and bowl set I got from the thrift shop, I've always wanted one of those, and I was surprised to find that exact same set is featured in a movie by Jeanette Oak. It was Love's Long Journey, which was really a surprise to my wife because she loves that series of books. In fact, Jeanette Oak happens to be a neighbor of my cousin, my bi-identical cousin Larry up in Canada. So that's kind of a hoot. But anyway, found a nice spot for this. It actually hangs my hat on it, and we're going to be using it. It's functional. And doesn't it look nice here now? Really nice. Anyway, that's it on my treasure hunting series. I want to thank you guys for showing up and sharing my adventure with us. We're a frugal homestead tucked high in the Cascade Ranges of the Pacific Northwest. Please stay tuned to more videos. You can do that by subscribing and clicking that bell icon. That alerts you to new videos as I upload them. I wanted to point out, too, that once in a while I feature products right here on this channel, and you viewers will go and buy those products from Amazon. I get a little bit of a kickback from that sale at the end of the month. It's that little kickback that I use to go out and shop with at the on the Craigslist or at the thrift store. So essentially all this stuff is free for me. I'm able to just furnish the whole house frugally. Champagne taste, beer budget. Anyway, be safe, always be kind. We'll see you guys in my next adventure. Bye-bye now.